How are we doing, Panther fans? So, George Richards of Florida Hockey Now earlier today provided us with a little bit of insight in terms of Coach Maurice saying that, actually, Ekblad's playing through a thing. He's playing through something. Also known as he's still friggin' hurt. So you might tell I'm aggravated, frustrated, obliterated, all of the tids. I'm all of it right now. Because when Ekblad was out, I produced this statistic early on after he had come back after about 5 or 6 games. I didn't reproduce it now, but I'm sure it's still holds. The best stretch of games that we had goals against wise this year were when Ekblad was out. And when I put out that statistic, somebody said, you're not suggesting this team is better off without Ekblad. Well, at this point, I am. Why is he out on the ice? If we know he's hurt, and a blind monkey can see that he is not, forget a number one NHL defenseman, he's not a bottom six capable NHL defenseman. He's not right, clearly. Now, whatever it is that he's working through, whether or not he re-injured the groin, never really healed the groin, I don't really care at this point. The season is 99% lost. Now, somebody else had said this was the place exactly in the record where the Blues had been and got hot. And then they went on to win the Cup. Okay, I mean, it's St. Louis, like Stu said to me. But technically, if you want to say, hey, it's happened before, you can't argue against that. But ain't none of this happening with Aaron Ekblad on the ice hurt. Why is he on the ice? I cannot express to you the level of frustration, aggravation, and everything else that I felt when I saw that. Because now, while I've been critical of Ekblad, don't get me wrong, I have been saying, I can't wrap my head around the idea that he has regressed this much, right? Come on, he's 26, he's had the leg injuries, but this is a falling off of the cliff regression. I keep thinking, he's got to be hurt. But then you look in that hand and you say, well, this don't make any sense either, because if he's still hurt, considering the results on the ice since he's come back, why is he out on the ice? We have a plethora of more than capable bottom six defenders, Kjærstad, Carlson, Pitetto. Now, we did trade away Delzato, but we've got guys, not to mention, you know, a couple of kids that maybe wouldn't kill us to bring up and see what they can do. Stahl has been playing adequately. Forsling, Montour, Marhura, Gudas is one of the best pairs in the NHL right now statistically. Now, I know Gudas hasn't looked great since he come back from his concussion. That's a concern, but I'll give him a little bit of time to play into shape. But Kjærstad Stahl, Carlson Stahl, Pitetto Stahl will be fine. At least they're functional players. Ekblad is not a functional hockey player right now. So this leads me to the same question that I posed in one of the earlier last couple recaps. Who's calling the shots? Is Zito Maurice's puppet? I mean it. Who's calling the shots? Can Zito say, hey, look, man, this dude ain't cutting it. Let's call up a kid. Let's put Ekblad on LTIR. Let's give him a month to heal up. And let just Kjærstad play with Stahl. We'll be fine. We were more than fine when Ekblad was out. So who's responsible for this? Because we're over here giving Maurice a bunch of hell. And you got to figure Maurice is the one responsible, obviously, for the product on the ice. But less and less and less and less and less, the more that I see of what Maurice is being able to get away with and do to this team, I'm perplexed and disturbed by what Bill Zito and the ownership is allowing to happen. We are becoming a laughingstock of a franchise right before our eyes. And it's not like Ekblad's gutting it out and still playing decent and making some plays. No, he's abysmal. He's terrible. Right now, give me the choice between what Ekblad is now and what Yandel was at the end when he was there in Florida. I take Yandel. At least he could distribute the puck on the power play. There's no palpable difference in terms of their ability to move and their speed and the stupidity of the plays that they make because they're physically unable to move. Yandel had an excuse. He was, 36, 37, however old he was. Now Ekblad's got an excuse. He's hurt. So why is he on the ice, coach? Why is he on the friggin' ice? What is happening to this team? I'm having a day. You know, between what happened last night, everybody knows what happened last night in the football game, and I see people fighting about that on Twitter, and part of my job is interacting with people, and I see what people say to each other, and it just makes me want to vomit sometimes. The stupidity of multiple angles. So I'm a little bit frustrated there. I did my yearly wrap up in terms of, I'm going to do a video on it. I'm going to let you guys know. I did one last year. I'm going to do another one this year in terms of how much money we make here on YouTube. So I did that, but that, I'm going to make that a separate video right now. It's not the time for that. So the point is I'm admittedly frustrated. And then I see this where Ekblad's still hurt. And, I thought we were in good hands, right? We like the owners. The owners, if they could get out of their own way, they're willing to spend the money. And it's really all you need out of your owners is just to say, hey, look, you got a blank check. What do you need, right? So then it falls to Zito. Now, Zito could fix this mess like that. You could say, I made a mistake. Kaputz. Maurice is gone. Maurice could fix part of this problem. Kaputz. Boom. Just like that. Ekblad, he's not right. I don't care about the name on the back. I don't care about the number on the back of the jersey. You're not right. You sit down for a month. And if we're out of the playoff race by the time you're ready to come back, rest. Because you're injury prone as it is. Because either he never healed from the groin, he hurt his groin again, or something else is wrong, which is clearly hindering his play. Why is he on the ice? Nothing pisses me off more right now than this team. It is just beyond palpably aggravating. So, we'll see what happens tonight against the Coyotes. We'll be back out here for a stream in a couple hours. Got a special guest coming at the beginning of the stream. Don't want to miss that. But any hope that this team has, you got to have healthy players on the ice. Oh, and my other suggestion. I was putzing around with the cap-friendly roster maker a little bit earlier today. And I got to thinking, the way things are going and the way people are looking at everything like that, how about putting Lundell in the second line next to Bennett and giving Lusterainen back 3C? So you'd have Barkov, Bennett, Lusterainen, Stahl, instead of Lusterainen putzing around on at two left wing, put Lundell there and give Lusterainen back 3C. Worth a shot. Anything at this point is worth a shot. At least those guys can skate. I can't believe Ekblad's hurt. He's working through something. I swear. It's a good thing I don't have credentials. I wouldn't last 2 minutes at a press conference with Paul Maurice. I wouldn't last 20 seconds. They'd have to drag me out kicking and screaming because the questions are so easy and obvious. And no disrespect to any of the guys down there, I understand completely. They can't ask the questions that they would really want to ask. But I'll ask it. Who's the moron putting Aaron Ekblad on the ice? Which one of you idiots down there in Florida is responsible for that? I ain't going to let this go. You're freaking ruining our damn season. See you tonight. Should be fun.